I have a story, and I do tell it on stage, but it's something that really happened to me, and I almost didn't tell it on stage because everybody talks about airplanes, but I had an engine blow up on a flight from L.A. to New York.
Recently?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
oh.
And first of all, it was like, by the way, if you really, you know, you knew it. Like, everybody knew something really bad happened. I look over, and I see the flight attendants looking out the window.
That's who you look at, the flight attendants, right.
And one of them was crying.
Whoa.
A crying flight attendant. So much for that, you know, hey, your safety is the most important. Those whores were crying and holding each other.
Did you have to stop? Where'd you land?
Oh, we stopped. We landed in 7 minutes. The engine blew up, and all of a sudden the pilot... Here's the thing. The pilot gave the creepy voice like, hey, hello, ladies and gentlemen. There's no reason to be alarmed. So if he got on the air and went... Whoa, did you feel that?
I'd rather have that.
Because then you would be like, yeah, he's not trying to snow me. Right. You know, I'm going to try something that I heard about at school. I can't promise you anything. You know, I felt a little better, but he's like, there's no reason to be alarmed, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, that's still my view.
He goes, we're going to land in Cleveland. Please put your seats in the back, you know, the whole spiel. And the plane just went, wah, like just a sharp, sharp turn and straight down. And we had landed in 7 minutes from when he made the announcement. There was a bunch of guys from the Olympics on the plane, and you're going, but you don't follow sports. How'd you know?
Yes, yeah, yes, yeah. Yes.
Special
the
Olympics.
The outfits. Oh, Special Olympics.
Special.
Team USA. I'm not kidding you.
No.
Yes.
Well, they don't know what's happening then.
Well, no, but I'm like going, oh, because then the pilot comes on again. Maybe it wasn't Team USA. They had running suits and
whatever. It was Special Olympics.
It was
Knoxville and
it was a giant hip hop group with Down syndrome.
Okay,
it wasn't Team USA. So because they had the running suits and the medals, and so I'm like, so the pilot comes out again and goes, "Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, there's no reason to be alarmed. We're gonna have some fire trucks on the tarmac joining us when we land. There's gonna be some fire trucks," and I'm like, "Oh." Oh, my God. So I'm really kind of thinking I'm going to die.
And so, you don't drink, so you couldn't mellow
up. No, my ego, yeah. I'm like going, who's getting top billing?
You know right. I mean?
Is it going to be Special Olympics, Bobcat Goldthwait Special? People are going to read it and go, see, I told you he was. You know what I mean? Like, like I don't know where this is. And this is, okay, hand to God. This is what I really hear. This is what I hear. I hear, fire truck. Honest to God. It's a true story.
Yeah, still bad. In the back of your mind, you fear you're going to be an afterthought if anything bad
happens.
Yeah,
but also at that point, you wish you were on that team.
Yeah.
Because you don't know what's going on.
Yeah, they would have been happy. Yeah. We're getting back on, and I know I need to tell this story.
Okay.
But I did that. Like, I took a picture.
Of what?
One of the fellas coming on because I wanted to tell the story of Team USA. But the flash is still on. So my phone...
And does it flash?
Everybody looks at me like...
Like you're taking a picture of a retail.
Yeah. But so what the guy does is the flash goes off and he turns around and looks at me and he just...
He posed.
Yeah, he posed. Like, it's like an action figure.
Like he's they're waiting for us to get off the plane.
Yeah, I like that everybody's corrupt. Like even these guys are like, I know, it's a fan. I gotta stop for the fan.